Okay. A new chapter. Chapter 6, Lineage. Episode 1. A new ally. Yeah, there's a... I think there's approximately 8 episodes in each chapter. Which I gotta be honest, I'm surprised that the game is that long. I really can't remember how long was the other game. I think the last game like had 20 episodes altogether. I kind of forgot, but some of the challenges here doesn't really give you a lot of variety, but still the gameplay is fun, which, you know, it's definitely the gameplay here holds up, because mainly because, you know, the gameplay itself is unique. You really don't play something like that at all, which is really glad that I got introduced to this series. Hopefully I'll be playing the rest of the games unrecorded, you know, hopefully later. Although I will try to see if I actually can do that without having a lot of hassles. I'm gonna try and find out. I'm gonna try and mimic some of the inputs that's hard to mimic for the Wii. Because if I'm gonna record the any of the future Trauma Center games, they're gonna be... I'm gonna emulate them, and of course I'll definitely have to use something that will mimic the Wii... what do you call it? Not the motion, not the remote, the other one, the nunchuck, yeah. The nunchuck motion, so... So I think I can mimic it, we'll see about that. Let's see, do we have any more rounds left?
Understood.
No, that was our last patient. Phew, this is even harder than I thought it would be. Ever since the HOA took their picks from our staff, we're all seeing a lot of a lot more patients. Huh, you're right. I wonder if we'll be able to get any new recruits to fill the positions. I don't know. I've heard that hospitals everywhere are facing the same shortages. I mean, hospitals having doctor shortages isn't something new, really. Like, I think this is something... it is coming. The shortage of doctors and engineers, I think that it's... most countries around the world actually face, especially when we're talking about the shortage of doctors in rural towns, cities, and villages. That is a big problem, because nobody wants to live in a rural village, really. But if this keeps up, it's really going to slow us down. Yeah, well, if you think we're being slowed down, you should have seen how angry Victor was. Who's Victor? He said the PGS research is suffering because, I think he means Dr. Nigel. He said the PGS research is suffering because Acropolis is prioritizing their HOA projects. It seems like all of Caduceus is having problems coping with this situation, yeah. Coping with this situation. Hello. Hello, viewers. My name is Have a Nice Day, and I can't speak English. Ah, there you are. Derek, would you mind if I borrow Angie for a bit?
What?
My waifu? Hands off the waifu. Something wrong, Tyler? What do you need me for?
Hey.
One of my patients has suddenly become unstable, and we need to operate immediately. And Leslie is helping Dr. Clarks with another operation, so I don't have an assistant. Are you serious? Angie, can you help? Certainly, Dr. Chase. Let's go. Thanks, Angie. I appreciate it. Then something tells me that the new recruit is gonna be that lady. Forgot her name. Mia? Maya? Mia Maya, those are characters from Phoenix Wright. I love the Phoenix Wright games, by the way, viewers. Things just can't continue like this. Attention, Dr. Stiles. You have a visitor in the waiting room. Ooh, a visitor. I wonder who that could be. Who's that? I think it's gonna be her. Yeah, I knew it. This is her. I think that's her. What's her name again? I forgot. Dr. Stiles, it's been a while. Miss Rose, how you been? Are you feeling okay? Yes, yes, actually. So far, there haven't been any signs of latent symptoms either. It's all thanks to the advance in guilt treatment and a wonderful doctor. Oh, shit. Great, I'm glad to hear you're doing well. But I'm about Emilio. Are you gonna bring that again? I'm sorry about before, I kind of lost it. As a nurse, it was unprofessional of me to criticize you on such a difficult decision. I apologize, Dr. Stiles. I hope you can forgive me.
No.
It was my fault, too. There must have been a better option. I still regret not being able to save Emilio. I mean, you can't save them all. That's the idea. Dr. Stiles. That's why I've got to make sure I don't make that kind of mistake ever again. This is my way of remembering Emilio and his last wish. To do everything I can make sure to make sure all of my patients pulled through. You read that really, really well. Have a nice day. I'm sure that Emilio. I think me joking about my shitty ass English is getting even stale, stagnant. So. I probably should, should either stop making jokes or stop making, making myself look stupid by mispronouncing and misreading sentences. Mm-hmm. Have a nice day. Mm-hmm. I'm sure that Emilio would be happy to hear you say that, but he's dead. I plan on making some changes in my life too, Doctor. In fact, that's why I'm here today. Oh, let's see. How can I help you? I'd like to apply to work here as a nurse. I've already cleared my potential transfer with Elysium. Wow, so really serious about this? Yes, I felt that I need a change of pace lately. Coming here would also improve my nursing skills, and seeing how Caduceus is so understaffed. Well, I think it's a great idea. I'm looking forward to working with everyone, assuming I meet the qualifications. I mean... Interesting. Is there shortages? I don't think there are shortages in nurses, in hiring nurses, that's for sure. I'll do my best to make Deuces proud. I'm sure you'll fit in just fine, Heather. Ah, her name is Heather. Alright, Heather Rose. Withered Rose? Heather Rose? You've got quite an impressive resume here. She has like an international license or something she was boasting about. Thank you. I take my professional development very seriously. I'm sure you're well aware, but we're facing a severe shortage of personnel right now. We'd be happy to have someone of your caliber help alleviate our staffing problem. Then, I got the job? Well, since you have surgical experience, we'll put you in that department for the time being. We'll evaluate your performance and go from there. Though, I'm sure there won't be any problems. Thank you very much, Dr. Casal. If you don't mind, I'd like to start getting familiar with the facility right away. I'm glad it all worked out, Heather. Yes, me too. What's with that? Excuse me a moment. This is Sydney. What? I see. Yes. All right. We'll admit him.
Derek.
The siren. It's not. It's part of the music. It's not someone. someone bringing someone, and we're hearing the sirens. We have Derek. We have an inbound emergency patient. It's another case of PGS. He's a 30-year-old male who has once infected with a treaty. The affected area is his stomach. I'm assigning this patient to you, Derek. Hmm? But Chief, and you're still assisting Dr. Chase in the OR. Well, we just hired a new nurse, Derek. That's right. You have the same nursing license as Angie, don't you? I'll assist you to the best of my ability, Dr. Stiles.
Let's begin the operation.
Alright, let's get down to the operating room. Yes, sir. Alright. I'm still waiting for that guilt type virus that was a puzzle. If that puzzle will pop up again, I think I'm gonna fail a lot before I do it. But I think I remember. I remember you can actually cheat your way with the healing touch. Like you can make it extremely easier. And if you want to do it without the healing touch, it would be absolutely extremely hard. So we'll see. All right, Thomas Hugh. He's not that tall. Damage to the stomach. Foreign objects detected. Extraction required. A stabilizer unavailable with limited supply of antibiotic gel. What the shit? We don't have a lot of antibiotic gel? How does the lack of supplies? How does the fact that we are understaffed affect the supplies that we have? What? That doesn't make sense. All right, game, whatever. Are you ready to begin? Are you ready to begin the briefing, Doctor? Yes. Does it bother you that Miss Thompson isn't the one assisting you today?
No.
No, of course not. Then I'll continue. As Chief Casal mentioned, our patient was infected with the treaty guilt in the past. Treaty. That's the guilt that hardens organs. Hardens organs. Correct. We've located some foreign bodies in his stomach, but we can't confirm that it's guilt. The X-ray shows these objects piercing the stomach wall. Thus, there are two objectives in this operation. Treat the injuries to the stomach. Two, extract the foreign bodies. Alright. First, we'll have to find out what these foreign bodies are. Are you ready, Heather?
What is this?
Wait, no. We don't have enough surgical tools. What? Of course. We don't have any syringes to inject the stabilizer with. What the shit? That's... So, are you telling me that if I fail and try to heal his vitality points, I can't do that? We'll see. And there's hardly enough antibiotic gel either.
What?
Damn. How could this happen? I guess we've been so understaffed that no one had the time to check the supplies. Doctor, maybe we should postpone the operation until... No. We've got to perform the procedure. Are you sure about that? What? The patient condition is worsening as we speak. If we don't treat him now, it may be too late. But doctor... Don't worry, we can still do this. Even with a limited supply. We just have to stay on our toes. It could have been bad if we found this out in the middle of the operation. Thank you, Heather. Now, let's get started. Right away. Well, I guess that's it. We are going.
Let's do this.
I'm beginning the operation. Yeah, we are gonna do it, huh? Alright, we'll see.
Dr. Stiles.
Let's begin the operation. I've never done this before, but I'll try my best, Dr. Stiles. Like I said earlier, keeping the patient's vitals up is going to be difficult. Alright. We can't inject the stabilizer, and this is all we have left of the antibiotic gel. We'll need to be very careful. Yeah, no, we can't use any syringes, huh? We'll see. There's severe hemorrhaging in the affected area. Please drain the blood pools first. Once you have a clear view, make incision where the foreign objects are lodged. Toxicosis has also set in, so don't forget to inject the sedative. So we can at least use the sedative to clear out the toxicosis. Okay.
Toxicosis has subsided.
Okay, one by one. One by one, I guess.
Doctor!
Doctor, what is this?
Yeah.
It's treaty, but it doesn't seem to be active. These may be its remains. I wonder, could this be a form of PGS? How are we going to treat it, Doctor? We'll have to be mindful of the direction they're lodged. Okay. We have to be mindful of the direction they're lodged in and extract them with the forceps. That means we'll need to extract all of those treaty remains first. Then we can apply synthetic membrane and the fix. Wait, what if we run out of antibiotic gel? We'll have no choice. I'll just have to suture the wounds, even though it will affect his vitals. Okay. Need to be careful here. Okay. Maybe someone will bring the... I'm doing it really, really slow, by the way, viewers.
Doctor, please.
Yeah, this is definitely. Yeah, this is where we need the healing touch for sure.
This is it.
Yeah, that's that. That's that. I need to suture. Suture. Okay. Oh! Doctor, no, we need to postpone the procedure until we get more supplies. Yeah, I guess I forgot that we needed to suture later. Yeah, I think I can do it without the healing touch. Yeah, I think I can do it without a healing touch. It's okay. I just need to be a little bit faster. Alright, it's fine. Usually, the first time we always lose. Once we learn what we need to do, we can optimize. Alright.
Alright.
I don't think you get penalized here. What if I... what if I actually try and drop all of the... what if I actually try and use the antibiotic gel and just, use it on the patient just to try and increase the vitality, since it doesn't It doesn't affect later. It doesn't matter. I don't think I actually need to maximize his vitals. But I need to be careful here.
Doctor.
It's okay. We already know what we need to do here. Maybe I should use drops here. All right. We don't need to use a lot. All right. That's it. Alright, I need to close him fast. We can't? Huh. I thought that's it. Because I don't have enough vitality. I can't do anything. If that's the case, if that's actually the case, then there is absolutely no choice other than me trying... other than... having to use... the healing touch. Otherwise, it would be impossible. Morrigan's color is changing, Doctor. Toxicosis has set in. Could there be wounds we haven't found yet?
Here's the ultrasound.
I don't see anything on the surface, but let's try looking with the ultrasound. I don't know. What the hell?
Dr. Stiles.
What the? Is this? What is this? Why did it suddenly start to hemorrhage? So were there? So there were some wounds left. Let's hurry and treat them.
Here's the drain.
Indeed. Please begin draining the blood.
Doctor,
yeah.
You need help.
It's the healing touch. I definitely need to use the healing touch. Let me think of a strategy here. Should I? I might actually need to use the healing touch for the first one. I'm gonna try with one more round. Without using the healing touch. One more time without using the healing touch.
Dr. Stiles, let's do our best.
Let me try this.
Please, doctor, please.
We're out. So, to restart. Yeah, I was exploring that if I actually can increase his vitality to the maximum, but no, I need to be careful because I have finite amount of antibiotic gel. So I actually at the very beginning here, I need to be really careful.
Doctors, let's do our best.
Yeah. This is what I need to do.
Please inject the medication. Doctor!
Yeah.
So we need to extract this carefully.
Toxicosis has subsided.
No! I was trying to pick the goddamn the drain.
Patient's condition. situation has worsened.
Oh, I've always forget to suck here. More hemorrhaging, huh? It's gonna be, Alright.
Dr. Style! Here's the drain.
Yeah, I don't think that's possible, dude. Yeah, that's not possible. I have to use the healing touch. This is absolutely, there is no way around it. I don't think there is a way for you to finish this without the healing touch. Absolutely not. Unless there's something I'm missing, at least in a way where I can actually force him to get vitality back. I know. But there is one way that you can do that. If you force him to go into cardiac arrest, you can restore like 10 or something like that. If only there is a way to for us to actually force that. But I don't think so. So yeah, I'm gonna use the healing touch here. Probably in the first section here. Nice.
Please inject the medication. Toxicosis has subsided.
Let's go.
Doctor.
Yeah. Shh.
This is okay. This is okay.
Toxicosis has here's the ultrasound.
All right.
Dr. Style, here's the drain.
Same thing. Nothing changed here. I think this operation is all about optimizing your performance. Extraction of the treaty remained. It looks like we're done now. Hopefully? I mean, can we do anything else if something happened now? It looks like we're done now. Yes, the toxicosis seems to have completely subsided. thank goodness. That concludes this treatment. Is it? Oh, we got it. All right. No, 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 no. Don't die. Don't die. Save! I was about to screw myself really bad, royally screw myself here, but good thinking that I actually immediately switched to the antibiotic gel, you know, to heal up. Wow! I did not think that was... Man, have a nice day. You are the best and the worst Trauma Center player to ever exist. The best and the worst. You're unique. Operation complete. Well done, Dr. Stiles.
The patient is saved. Barely.
Oh my goodness. Am I gonna get an A for this? Watch it as the game gives me an A for this. Membrane all wounds. This game sucks, dude. I fucked up majorly. You were giving me an A? Whatever, game. How the hell did that not count? You did a great job in there, Heather. Please don't tell them that I almost killed a patient. I'd say the operation was a success, thanks to you. Oh, goddamn. Thanks to the new waifu? Oh, hardly. I'm just honored to have been able to assist you, Dr. Stiles. Huh. Now you're embarrassing me. Nah, we actually did the we are capable of embarrassing ourselves, that's for sure. Chuckle. You really know what you're doing, though. I'm sure Chief Casal will have no qualms about making you permanent now. Keep up the good work. I'll try, Doctor.
Dr. Stiles!
Dr. Stiles, what room is the emergency patient in? Oh, Miss Rose, what brings you here? Long time no see, Miss Thompson. Actually, I just got hired. Today is my first day.
Huh?
What? Really? She'll be my assistant when you're helping the other doctors, Angie. Oh, I see. Miss Thompson, now I have a lot to learn, but I'll do my best to keep up. Of course, if you have any questions, just let me know. So, welcome. It'll be great to have a nurse of your ability to help us out around here. Right, Dr. Stiles? Yeah. She feels threatened. She feels threatened! Anathema? What the hell is that? Well, that's episode 2 for this chapter. Conference room, downtown. Where is that? Is this Acropolis? Police chief. To our knowledge, the current leader of Delphi is Heinrich von... I'm not gonna pronounce that name. It's also noteworthy that he is the grandson of the former leader, Austrian-born Eric von, I'm not gonna pronounce that name. Von, I'm not gonna pronounce that name. Senior is the man who engineered guilt, operating under the codename Adam. When Delphi was exposed 3 years ago, Heinrich's alleged participation was unconfirmed. But we know now with certainty that he played a role in the guilt research from the beginning. Who are they talking to? Can you tell us how the change in leadership has affected their ideology? Unfortunately, Heinrich's beliefs are essentially in the line with his predecessors. He rejects the very philosophy of medicine, claiming it violates nature's design. Delphi clings to their demented assertions that mass murder with guilt brings peace to mankind. Oh. Damn, the fucking Illuminati, huh? It's sickening to think that they could believe such ludicrous ideas.
Well...
Yes, they may not have as much power as before, but they are certainly still a viable threat. Especially knowing that they are capable of bringing about further evolution of guilt. I'm Detective David Buckley. Well, we know who you are. I'll be presenting the countermeasures we've taken against them thus far. We began coordinating an expensive search across most major cities for potential threats. Our priority has been on high population density areas that are more viable targets for them. We've also cross-examined the evidence obtained from prior raids with the confession of suspects. The intel has confirmed several likely Delphi hideouts near Angel's Bay and Santa Balboa. We are pressing to conduct full-scale investigation on these facilities as we speak. Mr. Chairman, may I have a word with the Assembly? You may, Mr. Mercer. My name is Patrick Mercer, CEO of the Hands of Asclepius. It is clear that the entire world must once again come to terms with the reality of guilt terrorism. Now, more than ever, we must unite in our efforts to stand strong against the ominous threat. We owe our thanks to the combined efforts of Caduceus USA and the UN for our previous successes. The final raid on the Delphi base still remains a testament to how effective alliances can be. Now, in order to truly annihilate them, we must rally under the banner of singularity once more. The Hands of Asclepius stand at the ready, and I am here before you to offer our full cooperation. Our doctor's healing touches are being further enhanced by the day, ready to face potential terrorism. However, the true purpose of my address to you today is to announce that the Hands of Asclepius have developed a weapon that may be guilt's final blow. What's it gonna be? A weapon? Whatever it is, it sounds like he has complete confidence in it. Let's see what he has to say. What kind of weapon? Oh shit. Nice portrait of goddamn I was about to say a nice portrait for goddamn Dracula, but this guy appears, and he's an actual vampire. Look at his ears.
I've returned from my assignment, Your Excellency. Our base of activities in Angel's Bay has been discovered, and 5 of our comrades were arrested.
What the? So this is the guy, this is his grandson, huh? Oh my goodness, a member of the BGC, the Bald Gaming Community. A bald vampire? That's, Wow. That's unfortunate. Oh, shit.
This is already our third location. It's just as the rumor said. The police in this country are exceptional.
Police in this country? Where are you from? Romania? Transylvania?
Do you think they acquired the location from those who were captured?
They may have talked, but I'm sure the police are also using other resources. They're closing on us, slowly but surely.
You think they'll find us here, my lord? No, the likelihood of that is slim for now. We've ensured that only a select few of our operatives know this location. But
even his voice acting is similar to me.
But are we just going to let them do this to us? Can't you hear the sirens, my lord? It's really annoying. I know it's part of the soundtrack, but it's really annoying. I'm kind of jumping, thinking that the SWAT is gonna going to raid us at any minute, my lord.
It would not be to our benefit to lose any more of our forces. Send an encrypted message to all of our comrades. The time has come to launch Operation Hades.
Oh, welcome to hell. Oh.
Right away, sire.
No shit. I picked the right voices.
My brothers, let us toast to the essential peace that guilt shall bring to the fortunate, and to the memory of our forefather, Adam.
Sir.
Zamhul.
I don't know what that means.
Zamhul. Let our judgment now be passed upon those blinded doctors.
Oh, you guys, you haven't heard my evil laugh? There is a potential that you guys can actually hear my evil laugh in one of the let's plays I did. You've never heard of my evil laugh? I only do it in special occasions, though. So. Maybe wait for it? Maybe I'm gonna do it in this playthrough? I don't know. There's a high potential, you know, with these characters. Alrighty. Widespread fear. New episode. Oh god, the sirens. Whispered fear. What shit?
This is a good location. Are you sure we haven't been seen?
Oh, damn, we can go outside. Well, I guess I think we addressed that. We addressed that he's a vampire that can, you know, walk in the sunlight. I think it's not until later that someone decided to make vampires, you know, in fictional writing, that they decided to make vampires, you know, be harmed from the sun. Although originally they lose their powers in the sunlight, and that's it. Like, vampires are actually normal people under the sunlight, and once nighttime comes, this is where they get their, you know, their superpowers, and they start becoming actual immortals.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're still in the clear. We have the wind on our side. The direction is perfect.
Oh, it's gonna be airborne? The infection is gonna be airborne?
The timer has been set to 2 minutes. Once airborne, guilt will spread all over the city. Our next target is the station. Let's move. Yes, let Operation Hades begin. Sinners! Prepare for your journey to your final resting place. For the glory of Delphi.